WWDC announced and sold out. John Browett joins Apple. Airfoil now a must-have iOS app. Nova 3 coming soon, and the Nook Glow is now shipping. It's Thursday, April 26, 2012, and this is iWeek. I'm Tim Chatton, and this is what's going on in the Apple world today. Good morning and welcome to another edition of iWeek. So first up today is the rather predictable announcement of WWDC 2012. Traditionally, Apple likes to do something the day after a quarterly earnings call, and this year is no different. WWDC got announced. So what did Apple announce? Well, WWDC will take place starting June 11th through June 15th at San Francisco's Moscone West Convention Center. Apple says that this year's WWDC will focus on both iOS and OS X Mountain Lion, with more than 100 technical sessions led by Apple engineers, along with the annual Apple Design Awards. More than 1,000 Apple engineers will be on hand for this event, offering code-level assistance and other advice for developing on the Mac, iPhone, and iPad. The company notes that it will post videos from all the technical sessions for free on the Apple developer website after the WWDC conference concludes, so that developers who can't attend can still benefit from those sessions. The tickets cost $1,599. They were available at Apple's website, with purchases limited to one per person and five per organization, which is a change from years past, where you could just have as many as you wanted, I believe. Ticket purchasers need to be members of the iOS Developer Program, iOS Developer Enterprise Program, or Mac Developer Program. So that's the announcement, and as you might have heard, I said tickets were available. I say were because they sold out. They sold out in around 2 hours. Tickets went on sale shortly after 8:30 a.m. Eastern Time, and sold out banner appeared right before 10:30 a.m. Eastern Time. So within 2 hours, these tickets got sold out. So what that means is West Coast folks had until 7:30 in the morning to buy their tickets, and Hawaiians like myself had until 4:30 a.m. to buy their tickets. So yeah, kind of early. Those that wanted tickets most likely had alerts set up, but even so, it is odd that Apple catered towards the East Coast. Normally, Apple does things on their own West Coast clocks. So there you go. Apple, as predicted, is doing WWDC in June, and they'll probably be unveiling iOS 6 at this event, which should be an exciting unveiling. So on June 11th, we'll have that keynote address where we find out all sorts of cool stuff going on in the Apple world. Besides announcing WWDC yesterday, it was also John Browett's first day at Apple. John Browett is Apple's new head of the retail stores. Apple pre-announced this hire back in January. John is Dixon's former CEO. Dixon's is an electronics chain down out in Europe. Besides John now working for Apple, is John getting a nice amount of Apple shares? John got around $60 million of shares that will only go up in value over time. So congrats to John. Hopefully he is able to improve the already great retail store experience and perhaps return it to its former glory days where Genius Bar has actually had a be awesome policy that I believe has fallen away over the years. Now let's move on to some app news. First up is a brand new version of the Airfoil speakers for iOS. Airfoil, for those that don't know, is a Mac application that lets you AirPlay audio from pretty much any Mac app to any Airfoil speakers. So you had this iOS app that did it before, and you had AirPlay speakers in the past. Well, version 3 is a huge update to this free application. The new version allows you, through an in-app purchase, to turn your iOS device into an audio AirPlay receiver for not only Airfoil on the Mac, but for any AirPlay device. This enables you to stream audio from your iPhone to your iPad or vice versa. You can even stream audio from iTunes to your iPad or iPhone. In prior versions, the app served as a way to only stream from Airfoil on the Mac to Airfoil on iOS. So I tried out this update and it works really well. It's $3 to upgrade your app to the Airfoil, to the AirPlay-enabled device update, my bobber, and it works really well. So I'd recommend buying this update for $3. You will need to update your app, and when you do that, it'll become a universal app for the iPad as well. So it's called Airfoil Speaker, and it's out now. In other app news is an update to Pedia Pen for iPad. Version 1.1 adds Retina graphics for this new iPad. Version 1.1 also adds the ability to rotate pages, add support for grouping documents in folders, which can then be synced to iCloud. Along with this release, Asmile also released PDF Pen for the Mac, version 5.8. The Mac version adds the ability to view documents in the iCloud folders, move and organize iCloud-based documents, and rename iCloud folders. It also fixed some OCR issues and dropped support for 32-bit Intel processors to comply with Apple's new policies. So Smile, that's what Smile did with their updates. They also announced a PDF Pen introductory price will go away on May 1st. So if you want the $10 price point for the iPad, grab it now. On May 1st, it'll cost you $15. PDF Pen for iPad is one of the best PDF apps out there, and I'd recommend picking it up now while you still get this introductory pricing. In other app news is Gameloft. The company just released a teaser trailer for their upcoming Nova 3 game, which is rumored to be powered by Epic Games' Unreal Engine 3. This is the third installment of Nova, as the title would suggest, which Nova stands for Near Orbit Vanguard Alliance, and is very much a Halo-type game. And this game will pick up with Kale Warden crash-landing towards Earth. Gameloft has been known for their console-quality mobile games, and Nova 3 does look to be just as high of a quality as it has in years past. Not much more has been revealed about this game other than the fact that it is coming soon to both Android and iOS. Thanks to the cults of Android for highlighting this trailer. And other app news is a new app for those that own Kindles and own a Mac. According to the cult of Mac, when you download and install Send to Kindle, you'll have the ability to send stuff to your Kindle. Send to Kindle will also appear when you control click on a file from the Finder or in the print dialog of any Mac app. You can download archived personal documents from your Kindle library or Kindle Keyboard, Kindle, Kindle Touch, Kindle for Android, Kindle for iPad, Kindle for iPhone, and pretty much any version of Kindle that's out there. So if you have stuff stored in Kindle, you're able to access that with this application. Not only can this app be used for sending documents, but it can be used for archiving your library remotely. Another neat feature is that you can send documents to Kindle directly from the print dialog in any Mac app, as I mentioned just a little bit ago. Send to Kindle is available for download now from Amazon.com, and it sounds pretty cool. So if you have a Kindle, I'd recommend downloading it right now. Last up in app news today is an upcoming update to Facebook app for Windows Phone 7. Version 2.5 will bring support for group chats, threaded messaging, tagging in posts, and the ability to like or delete not only posts, but comments as well. The photo pages have also gotten a visual refresh, and you can now tap on links and posts to go straight to the relevant content. So there you go. If you use Windows Phone 7, your Facebook life is about to get a lot better. Closing out the show today, I wanted to first share that the Nook Simple Touch with Glow is now shipping and received very favorable reviews from both Engadget and The Verge. The supply of this backlit-enabled e-ink reader is apparently limited, and the initial run has sold out. You can try to get it at the retail stores or just wait until mid-May to buy one online when supply is a bit better. So that's that. And last up today, I just wanted to simply acknowledge how amazing Apple's gross margin is. So when Apple sells you a device, they actually make a fair bit of cash on it compared to other companies. Dustin Curtis, or at D. Curtis on Twitter, shared these figures with his followers. HTC has 11% gross margin. So that's that. Samsung at 17%. Motorola at 25%. RIM at 27%. Nokia at 29%. And Apple at 47%. People ask me why Apple has $110 billion in the bank. That's one reason. They actually make money on the products they sell. Not because they're high price points, but because they have good margins. Well, that's what's going on in the Apple world today. If you like the show, please head on over to iTunes and leave a review of the audio version of the show. Also, if you're just an audio listener, check out the video version over at youtube.com/TCHATEN or over at iWakePodcast.com. And while you're at iWakePodcast.com, head over to iWakePodcast.com/again. That's where you can sign up for the paid version of this show, where you get an extra show a week, a 30-minute show on Saturday, where Jerome and I and different guests talk about Apple and what's going on in the Apple world. So head over to iWigPodcast.com/again to support the show financially as well as get some extra content. Join me tomorrow for another edition of iWig. Aloha.